यानिशा सर्वभूतानां तस्यां जागर्ति संयमी यस्यां जाग्रति भूतानि सानिशा पश्यतो मुनेः.
The self-controlled one awakes in that which is night to all beings. That in which all beings are awake is night to the seer, muni, sage. So he is giving a startling statement here. What is day to one is night to the other and vice versa. Why is he giving this? Because this is the precursor to verse 70 in which he is making a very important statement. You must appreciate, we have been listening from verse 54 onwards, right? Arjuna has been listening from verse 1 onwards. So maybe Krishna detected a slight loss of concentration in Arjuna, so he tries to regain his concentration by giving this staggering statement. But it is true. It is literally true. Introverts go to bed early. So, inward-looking people, by 10 o'clock, they're out, lights out. And they wake up early. Extroverts, party-goers, party-hard types, their day starts only at 10 p.m. They start functioning at 10. And by 4 o'clock in the morning, they're staggering back home. At that time, the introverted person is awake. So it is almost literally true. But this is not what he means. What he means is, extroverted people and introverted people experience a totally different world. Extroverted people are usually negative in their outlook because they have nothing positive to fall back on. Introverted people are very positive in their approach. You know, like a lot of people say, what do you think is going to happen to this country? We're all going downhill. What's going to happen? Sometime we'll bounce back. Which time it is, we don't know. But if we are doing our level best to combat the downward spiral, then we'll be positive. If we are lending support to the negative forces, of course we'll be negative in outlook. Extroverted people are usually pessimistic. Introverted people are optimists. Extroverted people are takers. Wherever they go, whatever they do, they're looking only at how do I benefit? What is the advantage to me? Whereas introverted people are givers at every level of their personality. Material, physical, emotional, intellectual, and spiritual. So because of this, extroverted people are constantly agitated, they are stressed out, they are tense and depressed. Introverted people, on the other hand, are happy. In this world, if you come across one happy person, thank your stars. Consider yourself blessed. So extroverted people devolve, they go downhill. Introverted people evolve. Now when it comes to a man of realization and the rest of us, we also experience two different worlds. We experience finitude. He experiences the infinite. We are caught up in the changing phenomena of the world. He is established in the changeless Brahman. We are getting tossed by the perishable world. He is rooted in the imperishable. So the changes that are taking place in the world don't affect him. We are focused on body, mind, and intellect. He is focused on Atman. Therefore, really there is no communication between the two. We are in two different states. Yet, it goes to the credit of these masters that they have succeeded in communicating, in inspiring us and laying down a precise pathway for different types of people to get to that state of perfection. For which, where do you begin? You must have a vision. You must think beyond your present limitations. You look at realized souls. Sant Tukaram was a simpleton, a simple person, and he had severe limitations. But he thought beyond that of the infinite and reached there. You know, in the movie, when he reaches the state of realization, and it's put dramatically that a chariot comes to carry him, he goes to his wife and says, and actually the wife was a terrible woman, constantly complaining and putting him down. Goes to the wife and says, you gave me your company right through my life, through the difficult periods. Now I'm going to be happy, I'm going to the state of realization, I'm going to God, will you come with me? And you know what she says? She doesn't even talk about her children. She says, who will take care of my cow? That is it. You have to think beyond present limitations. Think beyond the world. And when your focus is on beyond the world, your perception of what is happening in the world completely changes. Like Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, when he was sent by his elder brother to Calcutta, and he was sent to school. He came back one day from school and said, what are they teaching me? They're teaching me about the world. I don't want to know about the world. I want to know God. So he dropped out of school. What courage. Swami Vivekananda, Narendra, he was at that time, went around in search of people and he asked only one question, have you seen God? Most were so terrified by the question itself that probably they didn't even answer. But Ramakrishna gave a resounding positive answer. He says, yes, I see God as clearly as I see you. Then you have to identify with Atman. And this is the most difficult part because you have no idea what Atman is. Atman is said to be infinite, all-pervading, omnipotent. These are terms which the human intellect cannot understand. So since you can't understand it, you reject it. It's like the Americans, when they were looking for Osama bin Laden, apparently they gave out ads to the common people in Afghanistan saying, you will get $25 million if you give valid, correct information about Osama bin Laden's whereabouts. You know what happened? Nobody came forward to give it information. Not because they were scared, not because they were on his side, they just did not understand what $25 million was. So then the Americans had to do some hard thinking and converted the price to, you will get cows, sheep, I don't know, little bit of land, a home, which collectively was worth much less than $25 million. But that worked. In a multinational company, once the board in New York, they were one shot, one board member shot. So they decided to go on a PR drive. And they said, we will appoint the longest serving employee as a member of our board. And that longest serving employee happened to be a clerk in a remote factory in India. And when they went, the chairman of the company went, the managing director of the Indian thing went to him and said, congratulations, you are now a member of our board. He looked most unenthusiastic. So after some time, he went to his boss and said, "Boss, what's happening? Don't do this to me. I have worked so loyally for the company and I am about to retire in the next 3 months. I have responsibilities, I have to get my daughter married, so on and so forth. Why are you doing this to me?" So his boss said, "Do you understand what you've got? You're going to be a member of the board in New York." He says, "And you'll get so much, these perks you'll get this, that and the other. And in addition to everything else, you'll get 2% commission on net profit." So he didn't understand net profit, what it is, he didn't know. He only understood the two. So he looks at the boss and says, "Please boss, do me one favor, no. In addition to all of this, please retain my salary of 3,000 rupees a month." What is 3,000 rupees compared to 2% of net profit worldwide? But he couldn't understand. So therefore, he's not willing to let go of this. That is why in the Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, he actually quantifies what is the happiness that you will get on realization. I don't want to go into that. But it doesn't work. Even after studying all that, reading all that, you go back and say, "I want my car." It's like that clerk saying, "I want my 3,000 rupees. I want my dog." The other day somebody went all the way to Dombivli to look for a dog, to buy a dog. So I said, "Why don't you adopt a you baby? You'll be doing more service." So anyway, this is the vision that we are talking about. You know, it's like a billionaire once offered a scientist a huge corpus. And that scientist happened to be from a remote African country and did not know English properly. So when that billionaire offered him a corpus, he quickly said, "No, I don't want." You know what he thought? Corpse. So he rejected it. Similarly, friends, we are rejecting the spiritual. However much we advertise, however much we tell people to come, still half-hearted attempts. Because you don't understand. And that's the problem.